In this video, we're looking at different ways of asking a question in French.
Bonjour et bienvenue à Coffee Break French. Moi, c'est Marc.
Moi, c'est Pierre-Benoît.
And as Pierre-Benoît said, we are looking at questions today. This is all based on Pablo's question. Our listener, Pablo, got in touch and he asked, what's the easiest way of asking a question in French? Well, Pierre-Benoît, what is the easiest way of asking a question in French?
The easiest way is to say the sentence that you want to ask and at the end of it, just raise your voice to make a question.
So let's look at an example. What about, are you tired?
Well, as a statement, tu es fatigué.
Tu es fatigué. Okay, so we'll talk about Pierre-Benoît here being masculine, therefore fatigué with a masculine ending. Tu es fatigué. You are tired.
But if I use my voice, I can turn the statement into a lovely question. And that would sound like, tu es fatigué?
So asking the question, are you tired? Tu es fatigué? Raising your voice at the end, just like we can do in English in some ways. You're tired in that sense, tu es fatigué. But there's less of a sense of surprise there in French. It's just a normal way of asking, tu es fatigué, are you tired? So that's option one. There is another option. We could do something
different. The other option, Mark, is the inversion.
So in that case, we would say, es-tu fatigué, inverting our subject and our verb. So, es-tu fatigué? Are you tired? And that's just like in English, isn't it?
Exactly. It's exactly the same. So it should be quite easy to use.
And what about a third option?
A third option would be using a set expression. And when you put it at the start of the sentence, whatever follows is going to end up being a question. Okay. And that set expression is est-ce.
Okay, now this combination of letters here does look a little bit daunting for beginners. It, however, is actually really quite easy to say. Oops, I've missed out the tu es fatigué part there.
You just missed out the verb, Mark.
Yep. So, est-ce que tu es fatigué? Like that. So, run this together. Est-ce que?
Est-ce que tu es fatigué?
Are you tired? Literally, it means something like, is it that you are tired? But don't worry about that. It's just the question form. And as Pierre-Benoît said, it's a set phrase. Est-ce que tu es fatigué? So you can put it in front of your statement and turn your statement into a question. Let's go back through those three question methods again. So each of them mean, are you tired? Let's do number one.
Tu es fatigué?
Okay. Number two.
Es-tu fatigué?
And number three.
Est-ce que tu es fatigué?
Très bien. Okay, so let's apply this to some other questions. Perhaps something about the past. What about, have you slept well?
Tu as bien dormi?
So we've got, tu as bien dormi. So that's just the statement turned into a question. Tu as bien dormi? Have you slept well?
We're just using our voice again, raise our voice to turn the statement into a question.
Or we could use the inversion form there.
Yep. So then we've got to invert the tu and the a. So it becomes, as-tu bien dormi?
As-tu bien dormi? So have you slept well? Again, exactly the same as the first one, just inverting the subject and the verb. As-tu bien dormi? Or using our est-ce form.
Est-ce que tu as bien dormi?
Est-ce que tu as bien dormi. Now, as I'm writing these out, you can be repeating along. So, est-ce que tu as bien dormi? Have you slept well? Is it that you have slept well? Est-ce que tu as bien dormi? One more time from you, Pierre-Benoît.
Est-ce que tu as bien dormi?
Très bien. Okay, let's change the subject here. What about they? Have they seen the film?
Well, we use then the first one, which is just a statement, and we're going to raise our voice. Mm-hmm. So, ils ont vu le film?
Ils ont vu le film, statement, and then make it into a question by raising your voice. Ils ont vu le film. Have they seen the film? Let's invert that.
Well, that's a wee bit tricky because the T of ont, which is going to be our first word, is going to have to liaise with the I of ils. Mm-hmm. So it's going to sound like ont-ils vu le film?
Okay, so when we make the statement, ont doesn't have a T pronounced at the end, but here, because it's following, or it's followed by a vowel, ont-ils vu le film, we do make it sound ont-ils vu le film?
Yeah, because ont-ils vu would not make any sense. Yeah, so we need strange. To have that T being pronounced.
Okay, and what about est-ce que?
Est-ce qu'ils ont vu le film?
Est-ce qu'ils ont vu le film? Have they seen the film? Each time it means the same thing. So let's go through these ones. We've not done the tu as bien dormi again. So let's go through all of those as well. So have you slept well?
Tu as bien dormi?
Second option.
As-tu bien dormi?
Using the inversion and then the est-ce que form.
Est-ce que tu as bien dormi?
Voilà. Okay, and now have they seen the film?
Ils ont vu le film?
Right, and the inversion form?
Ont-ils vu le film?
Watching your T sound there, so just taking care to pronounce that. Ont-ils vu le film? And our last one?
Est-ce qu'ils ont vu le film?
Super. Okay, one final thing here. And this is if we're talking about he or she, because there's something else that happens. And it's a little bit related to that T sound in there, in ont-ils vu le film. So, Pierre-Benoît, she is eating some ice cream. How would we say that?
Elle mange de la glace.
Elle mange de la glace. As a statement, elle mange de la glace. Making it into a question by raising your voice.
Elle mange de la glace?
Is she eating some ice cream? But when we do an inversion, when your verb ends in an E, we have to add something else to make it sound nice. So how would we say this?
Well, then we need to take a letter, which is the T, mm-hmm. which is going to allow us to make a liaison. Mm-hmm. But the T will be preceded and also followed by hyphens.
Yep. So we make this into mange-t-elle de la glace? Try that.
Mange-t-elle de la glace?
So does she eat ice cream? Is she eating ice cream? So that's a little more tricky, that one. let's make the statement. Just a statement, first of all.
Elle mange de la glace.
And make that into a question with our question mark.
Elle mange de la glace?
And then finally, our liaison here with our inversion version.
Mange-t-elle de la glace? I'll say it again. Mange-t-elle de la glace?
Très bien. And of course, we could equally say, est-ce qu'elle mange de la glace? That works perfectly well for that one. Okay, so hopefully this has answered Pablo's question. The easiest way is, of course, simply raising your voice making the statement and making it sound like a question by raising your voice at the end. Now, talking of questions, if you have a question, then simply get in touch with us. And you can head over to coffeebreakquestions.com, where you can send us your question, and hopefully we'll be able to include your question in a future episode of our show. And of course, if you've enjoyed this video, if you found it useful, then make sure you give it a like and subscribe to our channel. Hit that little bell icon that appears to be notified when we release new videos.
And try to practice your questions as well. And if you have an example that you'd like to share with us, please put it into the comments, post it in the comments.
Très bien. Bon, merci beaucoup, comme d'habitude.
Merci beaucoup à toi et à vous tous.
Et à la prochaine. Salut.
Salut.